Hi everyone, welcome to Established Kids This Week. We're so excited that you're joining us, whether that's from home and you're tuning in online, or whether you're with us in person at our watch party at church. It's so good to have us all together in whatever way so that we can keep learning about Jesus. And at the moment, we just started a new series last week about prayer. We're using this lovely book called What Every Child Should Know About Prayer by Nancy Guthrie. And it's full of so many awesome ways that we can pray to God, and it helps us learn so much about prayer. So we're going to read a little bit more now. This chapter says, we can use our bodies to help us pray. We can pray with our eyes tight shut or with our eyes wide open. Praying with our eyes closed can help us to focus on God. Our hands can be folded or lifted up or holding someone else's hand. We can bow our heads or look up to the sky. We can stand or kneel on the floor or sit in a chair. What matters most is that our minds are set on God and our hearts love God. There's a Bible verse here from Psalm 63, and it's verse 4, and it says, I will praise you as long as I live, lifting up my hands to you in prayer. What can you do with your body to help you focus on God when you pray? That'd be a really good thing to think about and to work out different ways that you can use your body to pray. Maybe that's something you can talk to your mum and dad about tonight. As you pray together, you could say, I'm going to lie down this time and close my eyes. Or maybe you could sit up. Maybe you can hold their hand. You have a chat to them and see what way you can use your body to pray. We can pray anywhere. We can pray with other people or by ourselves. We can pray at the table or in the car. We can pray while we're brushing our teeth or making our bed. We can pray when we're in a big crowd of people or when we're alone in our room. God really likes it when we talk to him in secret, and he doesn't like it when we try to impress other people with our prayers. There's a verse from Matthew, and that's chapter 6, verse 6. It says, but when you pray, go away by yourself, shut the door behind you, and pray to your Father in private. Then your Father, who sees everything, will reward you. We can pray, God, it makes me happy to talk to you no matter where I am. Isn't that such an awesome thing that we can pray to God anywhere and everywhere, no matter where we are? And as we use our body in different ways, in different places to pray to God as well, that's a helpful thing to remember, isn't it? That if we're in the car, we're going to be sitting up, but that doesn't mean we can't pray. If we're going for a walk, we'll be walking, obviously, and standing, but that doesn't mean we can't pray. We can't close our eyes when we're walking, but we can still pray. And God loves to hear our prayers. It's lovely to pray by yourself when you're praying in your mind quietly so that only God can hear you because he knows what's in your heart. But it's also really encouraging to pray together as a family or with one other person or in kids out loud because you get to hear each other's prayers and encourage each other with that. So I'd encourage you today to pray together as well as by yourself. We can pray about everything. God wants us to talk to him about everything. He wants us to talk to him about the things that make us feel afraid and the things that make us feel happy. He wants us to tell him what we need and thank him for everything he has done for us. Nothing is too small or too big to talk to God about in prayer. And there's this great verse from Philippians, and this is actually your memory verse at the moment. It says, don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. I think this version might be slightly different, but it says, tell God what you need and thank him for all he has done. I wonder who of you remembered the memory verse this week. Maybe it's a good time to have a think about it right now and see if you can remember it, because we're going to encourage each other with that memory verse very soon. The last question to think about is, what are some things that you can talk to God about? Remember, we can pray about everything. So you've got to have some things to talk to God about. We can thank him. We can say sorry to him. We can ask him for things. We can tell him how wonderful he is. There's so many things we can talk to God about. So let's do that together in Kids Today.